And this will make the calculation more easier, that now from here I can write that when k is equal to n pi, then k is equal to n pi over a, where n is equal to this thing. So we have reached our solution, because we put the things equal to k, and finally we got the value of k. So it means we have reached the solution, and now I can write that the solution is equal to v of xy is equal to, where's our final solution here, ce, so it is c and e to the power and minus kx. So for k I can put that value, and sine of ky, so I can write that this thing is equal to c e to the power minus n pi over a, and x here, and sine of k again n pi and y over a. So this is the final solution that we got here. Now if you look at that equation, we have not yet applied our very important boundary condition, that v is equal to v naught when x is equal to 0. And that is what we will apply. But the first thing, let's discuss the reasons behind this thing, that we, for one solution, we wrote the solution in the form of exponential, while the other solution we wrote in the form of sine and cos. And the reason behind that one is that if we would have selected this sinusoidal, like in the form of sine and cos, then we would have not reached our condition that v equal to 0 when x goes to infinity, because it is very easy to achieve in the form of exponential this thing, while it is not possible to achieve this thing in the form of sine and cosine. So that was one reason. And then what was the reason that we selected sine and cos here, means not the exponential. So if we would have written them in the form of exponential, then we would have not been able to apply this boundary condition. The boundary condition that says that v vanishes at y equal to 0 and y equal to a, so we would have not reached this solution if the things would have been in exponential. So that is what means we look at the geometry, and then we look at our mathematics, how under the mathematical rules we can use a trick to solve our geometry easily and to avoid going into a very tough situation where we have no way to go out of it. So these are the mathematical tricks that we have utilized. But now, when this is a solution, v of xy equal to this one, and if I put it here, del square v equal to 0, and here if I put, then I will find out that this is not solving it. The CE to here, when I will find a double derivative with respect to this one, then I see that this is not, you can say the derivative will continue and I will not get, means this is not finishing. And when I go to the y, then this is sine and it will become cosine, and then for the next it will become again sine, so it will also go on. So it means that these individual solutions are basically not doing the job. And for that reason, when we are having solutions that are not doing the job, then we go for some linear combination of those solutions. So for example, like if v1 v2 v3 are the solutions of the Laplace equation, then it implies that del square v is equal to alpha 1 and del square v 1 plus alpha 2 del square v 2 and alpha 3 and so on. The alpha 1 and alpha 2, they are the undetermined constants because we have written this in the form of a linear combination. So what will be that when we will determine the values of alpha 1, alpha 2, which are arbitrary constant, then it is possible that alpha 1 is equal to alpha 2 is equal to alpha 3 and so on, and this is equal to 0. So it will give us the solution. Means the thing here is that we are having the involvement of n here, where n is an infinite series here. So this will, the very first one will become n like one value, then that value will be here as well, but C constant is not supposed to be repeated with them. Okay, C means one is, let's say C1, the other is supposed to be C2, C3, because these will be the constant which will determine the coefficient or the amplitude of the rest of the variables. So we can write that this is basically, this can easily be written in the form that the solution will be in the form like this, V of X, Y, and this is equal to summation on n, and this n runs from 1 to infinity here, n runs from 1 to infinity, and then this C will become Cn, because for every n different constants will be there, and then e to the power minus n pi x over a, and then sine of n pi, sine of n pi y over a. So this is the generalized solution, or means it is a linear combination of that solution, that C, first it will be C1 E minus phi or X, this, and this will be one. When we will determine the Cn value, then it will become the solution of this equation. The next means like they are being added is a linear combination, and we will have those solution such that when we will put here that all these things, that when we will put V of 0 and Y, means when we put X equal to 0 here, then we will have summation on N from 1 to infinity, and then Cn here, and is X is 0, so this X is 0 means that e to the power 0 in something having power 0 is equal to 1. So we are left only with this sine of n phi y over e sub this side, and then this is supposed to be equal to v naught of y. This is the potential on the y. So with all means in order to fit the boundary conditions, then this thing is supposed to be equal to v naught y. So we are now having this solution, and further the key thing here is that we will have to find the value of Cn. When we find the value of Cn, we are done with our geometry or with our example. So we will go for the value of Cn, and in order to find the Cn value, we will utilize a trick. In order to calculate this thing, we will utilize a trick which is called the Fourier trick. And with the help of the Fourier trick, we will determine the value of Cn. Although this trick that we will utilize is called the Fourier trick, however, Euler has used this thing much earlier than Fourier. So even though the name is now famous after Fourier, it's called Fourier trick, we have utilized this thing in quantum mechanics or in other branches of physics as well, or in mathematics we utilize basically this Fourier trick. So our job is now to determine the value of Cn. Now, in order to determine the value of Cn, we will use the Fourier trick, and here it is. Let me write this in integral form, and to do this thing, we are writing as we derived that v naught of y is basically equal v naught y is equal to summation on n runs from 1 to infinity, and Cn sine of n pi y over e, because we are putting x equal to 0 here, sine of n pi y over a is equal to v naught of y. When x is equal to 0, then we will have the value v naught y. We will be reaching this strip of potential. So here, let's multiply both sides with sine of n prime pi y over a and integrating both sides. So we will get this one, that summation on n from 1 to infinity and Cn, and integration, we are integrating from 0 to a, which is the length of our strip here, and sine of n phi y over a, this is basically the expression that we have here. So we are going to multiply this with sine of n prime phi y over a, and then we will integrate it with dy. And this is equal, this side, what this will become, this is from 0 to a, the integration, and v naught of y, sine, multiplying by this again, so here n prime, pi y over a, and dy. Now we know about this side that this is basically the Kronecker delta. This is equal to a over 2 delta n prime. That is, when this is equal to 0, if n is not equal to n prime, and this is equal to a over 2 if n is equal to n prime.